If you've got a problem and you don't know what to do, find a piece of paper and write down what you're going through. If you need an answer to a question in your life, send a note to Wally. He's always got some good advice. Write a little letter.
Write a little letter.
Drop a little note.
Drop a little note.
Make a little stand.
Make a little stand.
Let's take it on an envelope. Put it in the mail.
Put it in the mail.
Before the postman comes.
Let us hear from you at Guidepost Junction.
There are lots of stories we would love to share with you. Wally and the Post Kids may even sing a song or two.
In our big computer, we can put the cards you write, and before you know it, out pops a lesson good for life.
Write a little letter.
Write a little letter.
Drop a little note.
Drop a little note.
Make a little stand.
Make a little stand.
And stick it on an envelope.
Stick it on an envelope.
Put it in the mail.
Put it in the mail.
And before the postman comes, let us hear from you at Guidepost Junction.
Let us hear from you at Guidepost Junction.
I can dance, dance. In my heart, I can rock and I can roll. Oh, I can't sit still. I got the dancing fever. Oh, I can jitterbug. Da 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 da. I can minuet. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Oh, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Oh, feeling good today, Wally?
I sure am, Jody. How can you tell?
Well, because whatever it is you're doing seems to be making you very happy.
What do you mean, whatever it is I'm doing? I'm dancing. Haven't you ever seen a turtle dance before?
No, not quite like that.
Oh, I suppose you could do better, huh?
No, Jody.
Oh, yeah, Jody, dance him into his shell.
Oh, well, I'll try.
All right. Oh, that's enough. You win. Can I help it if they wouldn't let me into dancing school because I'm a turtle?
You should have tried to get into martial arts school. I hear they let turtles do that.
And besides, it doesn't matter if you're a better dancer or a better athlete or a better whatever than somebody else. All that matters is that you believe in yourself enough to try.
But I don't think I could ever dance like you, Joey.
Well, sure you could, Leroy. Hey, but you never know unless you try.
And I'm not very good at sports.
But you try.
That's right.
Yeah, I guess I'm the lucky one. I'm perfect in every way. I don't even have to try.
Oh, please.
I'm kidding.
Urgent Wall email coming in. I got it.
Oh, good, Leroy.
Yay. Oh, boy.
It's from a girl named Danielle. Oh, no. This is sad. She has plastic cerebral.
It's spastic cerebral palsy.
What's spastic cerebral?
It's spastic cerebral palsy. It's a muscular disease. It makes it hard for someone to walk or move normally like other people.
You mean she has to use crutches?
Actually, I'm afraid it's more serious. Listen. Dear Wally, I'm Danielle, and I have SCP. That's short for spastic cerebral palsy. I have friends, but it hurts me to see people walking. I have leg braces and try to walk, but I can't. so I'm in a wheelchair. And I get stared at a lot. It's embarrassing. I've talked to people before, but they don't understand. I don't know what to do. Signed, Danielle.
You mean she'll never walk?
Probably not.
That means she can't dance or play or do anything.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. You'd be amazed at what people, especially physically challenged people, can do when they put their minds to it.
What do you mean?
Well, how about a for instance, Lauren Reynolds. She's a 14-year-old girl who holds national records in both swimming and track and field. And she also plays basketball and tennis.
Wow, she sounds really talented.
Just wait till you hear the rest. Imagine this. You're at a swimming meet and the gun goes off starting the race. The swimmers dive in and start swimming their hearts out. Faster and faster they go until finally one girl emerges victorious. She not only wins the race, but she sets a brand new all-time fastest record. And you know what she does then?
I bet she goes pro.
No. She climbs out of the swimming pool and into her wheelchair.
No way!
Yes way! You see, Lauren has what's called osteogenesis imperfecta, which is a disease that causes her bones to break easily and it weakens them. So she started swimming when she was very young to help make them stronger.
Did it work?
I'll say it did, because today she's not only a champion swimmer, but she also competes in track and field events too. Yes, she runs in wheelchair races, and she throws the discus, the javelin, and the shot put.
Is that real?
Oh, you better believe it. In fact, her dream is to compete in the Paralympics someday, and then play on the wheelchair basketball and track teams at the University of Illinois.
Wow! How does she do it?
She tries.
Ah, you're right, Wally. And she finds the strength to try through her faith in God.
And it's her faith in God that gives her faith in herself.
Hey, LaVoy, what are you doing?
I'm trying to dance like Jody. I maybe still can't, but I have faith.
Yeah, you know what else might help, LaVoy?
Special dancing shoes?
No, music.
picture I drew of Lauren dancing in her wheelchair.
Oh, that's great. And who's this other girl?
That's Danielle. She's dancing with her.
I tell you, we all have things we can't do. So a handicapped child is no different than any of us.
Wally, you're a genius. Oh, that sounds like the perfect guidepost for our story.
Come on, guys. Let's draw some more pictures of Lauren and Danielle.
Yeah.
Look out, world. Here they come.
Wow, those look great. What are they?
These are my mom's super duper brownies. She makes them special just for me because she knows they're my favorites.
Wow, can I have a piece of one?
Sorry, this is all I have.
But you have two of them there. Can't you share a little, please?
Yeah, I want some too. But they're my favorites. Here, you can have some of my apple if you want, or some of these crackers.
We don't want those. We just want to taste the super duper brownies.
Well, you're not going to because they're mine, and my mom made them just for me.
Hey, what's going on, everybody?
Yeah, what's all the discussion about?
Megan's got special brownies, and she doesn't want to share.
Oh, I'm sure that's not true.
But they're mine.
Uh-oh. Sounds to me like it's time for another letter. Where's that one we were talking about during lunch, Dodie?
Ha, got it right here, oh great green one.
This letter is from a girl named Holly in Jonesboro, Georgia, and it says, Dear Wally, I have a problem with a boy in my homeroom class. I'm not trying to be mean by saying this, but he smells terribly, like he never takes a bath. Please help me deal with this problem.
Now, wait a minute. How does some kid who never takes a shower have anything to do with not sharing brownies?
Jody? Oh, master storyteller.
All right, guys, gather round. I'm going to tell you the true story of Jose's feet.
Jose's feet?
That's right. Now, Jose is a homeless man who came to the shelter for the homeless in California. Now, homeless people don't always have a place to bathe or shower like we do. Well, so he stumbled into the shelter, took off his shoes, laid down on his cot, and fell fast asleep, when suddenly people realized there was a big problem. Jose's feet smelled horrible. I mean, they really stunk. Of course, everybody went crazy.
You gotta do something about that man's feet, Rodney.
Yeah, spray them with something.
Dunk them in something. Cut them off.
Everyone gathered around poor Rodney, and a big fight almost broke out.
Why don't we all drag him outside? Let him sleep out there.
No. Drag him outside isn't the answer.
That's right. You ain't taking that man anywhere. He's a friend of mine.
Well, then you clean him up.
I ain't touching those feet. That ain't my business. But I ain't gonna let you take him out of here either.
Oh, yeah? Well, who's gonna stop us?
Me.
And me.
Well, somebody do something here.
Then all of a sudden...
Anymore.
Hey, look!
Young Rodney had taken it upon himself to quietly and gently wash Jose's feet. First one filthy foot, and then the other. Until before you knew it, Jose's smelly feet were as clean as the day he was born.
Why'd you do that?
Somebody had to.
And that's all he said. And all those people who were ready to fight each other only moments earlier just stood in stunned silence until one by one, they all began to smile.
To glorify
Jose's feet.
Did he ever wake up?
Well, as a matter of fact, he did. The next morning. And when he did, what do you think he found waiting for him? A room full of friendly smiles and a fresh pair of socks.
Hey, where'd these come from? I do believe you got yourself an angel, Jose.
And we mean truly angel of mercy.
Because it's the little acts of kindness we do that show God's great love.
And that's a perfect guidepost for the story.
Here, Leroy. I'm sorry I was so selfish. And here, you guys. You can have some, too. Wally, Jody.
Why, thank you, Megan. Yo, that's good. You're right, they are really good.
Megan, now you don't have any.
That's okay. I have more at home. And besides, just seeing how much you guys like them makes me even more proud that my mom makes them so good.
That a girl.
Here, Lexi, put this one on that pile over there, please. Hey, good hands. Catch this one, too. Here, Lexi. Try again.
It's a good thing envelopes aren't breakable.
I can't help it. I can never catch very well.
Who can't catch very well?
Alexi.
No big deal. All you have to do is practice. Here, Alexi. Try and catch this.
Oh.
See? I just can't do it. I'll never be able to do it.
Hey, did I hear someone say never?
Yes.
Hey, Wally, where's that photograph of that little boy who thought he'd never amount to anything? You know, the one who everybody used to tease because he was so big and chubby.
Oh, you mean Mike Hall.
Who's Mike Hall? He's someone who couldn't catch very well either.
No. Actually, Mike Hall's a little boy who could catch just about everything that was thrown his way.
Wow. He's huge.
Boy, is he ever. They must have teased him bad.
So, what did he learn to do?
Well, everybody, come on over here and Jody and I'll tell you all about it. Come on.
You see, Mike Hall was always big, ever since the day he was born. In kindergarten, he was the biggest kid in his class. Oh, and by the time he got to grade school, forget it! He was the biggest kid in the whole school. And all the other children teased him to no end. Oh, you can just imagine the names they called him.
Yeah, like Turtlehead. Well, that's what they called me. But it still hurts.
So anyway, Mike got tired of all the teasing and he decided to do something about it. So do you know what he did?
Sat on people?
No. He started weightlifting. He cut off a sturdy tree branch and slipped some concrete blocks over the ends of it. And he used that as his weight bar. And when that became too easy, he just kept adding more weights until finally, little chubby Mike Hall wasn't so chubby anymore. He had become big, strong, muscular Mike Hall.
Wow, look how big he is.
He started competing in weightlifting events all over the country. And when other weightlifters were using drugs and steroids to make themselves bigger, Mike always said no. Because his philosophy was, God made him big and strong, and that's all he needed, the gift God gave him. And today, Mike Hall has taken that gift and become the strongest man in the world.
Wow, in the world?
In the whole world. So you see, Alexi, it doesn't matter. Just because you can't catch very well doesn't mean that you can't have a special gift from God too.
What do you mean?
Wally.
Listen to this, guys. This is a letter a little boy wrote to me, and it's one of the smartest letters I've ever received. It says, Dear Wally, I have ADD, or attention deficit disorder. I used to ask God why he gave me this problem, but then I thought about how it helped me. I had to work harder than the other kids in school to get good grades. Now I'm in the eighth grade and I make A's and B's on all my report cards. God turned my weakness into a strength, and all I had to do was lay it in his hands. I'm so glad I know a God who cares, and it's signed Matthew.
Now do you understand?
I think so. It's like, since I can't catch very well, that means I have to work harder at it to learn. Which means maybe someday I might be better than a lot of people, because I did work so hard. Is that right?
That's abso-turtle-lutely right. With you and God working hard together, there's nothing you can't do.
That could be the guidepost for our story. Be strong in the Lord.
And exercise the gift God's given you.
Oh boy, I like exercise. Me too.
Me great. Here, Alexis. Catch.
I guess I should start working hard right away, huh?
Well, we've heard three very good, very special true stories today.
And we've uncovered three very good guideposts, starting with...
We all have things we cannot do, so a handicapped child is a lot like you.
Oh, yes, that's right, Shira. Good job.
And what's next, Megan?
Little acts of kindness show God's great love.
Terrific. And last but not least...
Be strong in the Lord.
Exercise the gift God's given.
Great.
Hey, that was a nice catch, Alexi. Hey, it's easy when you got four hands.
Four hands? You don't have four hands.
Sure I do. Mine and God's.
Here, Alexi, catch this with your four hands.
Wow.
Now do it to me.
Almost.
And speaking of exercise, I think I'll go exercise my fingers and my brain and write a few letters to some very special kids.
Good idea. And I think I'll go exercise my brain by reading a good book.
You mean the good book, don't you?
You know me so well, Wally.
Yeah. Dear Matthew, it is great to have a God who cares about us, isn't it?
If you've got a problem and you don't know what to do, find a piece of paper and write down what you're going through. If you need an answer to a question in your life, send a note to Wally. He's always got some good advice. Write a little letter.
Write a little letter.
Drop a little note.
Drop a little note.
Make a little stamp.
Make a little stamp.
And stick it on an envelope.
Stick it on an envelope.
Put it in the mail.
Put it in the mail.
Before the postman comes.
Let us hear from you at Guidepost Junction.
There are lots of stories we would love to share with you. Wally and the Post Kids may even sing a song or two.
In our big computer, we can put the cards you write. And before you know it, out pops a lesson good for life.
Write a little letter.
Write a little letter.
Drop a little note.
Drop a little note.
Make a little stamp.
Make a little stamp.
And stick it on an
envelope.
Put it in the mail.
Put it in the mail.
Before the postman comes.
Let
Children are my passion. And here at Guideposts, we care about kids. Well, that's why we're so excited about our new magazine, Guideposts for Kids. For our special introductory price of just $13.95, you'll receive 6 big issues, a year's worth of facts and fun and faith.
There are games, puzzles, poems, a fun trivia calendar, even a true super comic in every issue. And my favorite, Dear Woe, I've Got This Problem, where real kids ride in with problems just like mine.
It's not easy being a kid these days. Guideposts for Kids can be a great addition to your mailbox. Call or write to us to subscribe. Boys and girls, ask your parents before you call. Tons of exciting things are happening in Guideposts for Kids, so don't miss any of it.